In the coastal city of Jeddah, Saudi Arabia, an architectural wonder is taking shape that promises to be unlike anything the world's ever seen. After a 5-year wait, construction of the Jeddah Tower, the world's tallest man-made structure, is back underway. But the UAE, home of the current tallest building in the world, Burj Khalifa, is already hitting back. And if they get in their way, there's a chance the legacy of Saudi's desert giant might be eclipsed before it even begins. The Jeddah Tower, formerly known as Kingdom Tower, aims to be the first structure in human history to break the 1 kilometer mark in height, rising over 200 meters taller than the current record holder, Dubai's iconic Burj Khalifa. The Jeddah Tower's captivated imaginations across the globe. But this ambitious project faced numerous challenges over the past decade, leading many to doubt whether it would ever be completed. That's why the recent announcement that construction has resumed after a 5-year hiatus has generated so much excitement and intrigue. In this video, we'll explore the conception, vision, and design behind this pioneering skyscraper. We'll look at the daunting engineering obstacles it had to overcome, and analyze what the Jeddah Tower's revival means for Saudi Arabia, the Middle East, and the world. Finally, we'll see how Dubai, home of the Burj Khalifa, isn't giving up the mantle of the world's tallest without a fight. There's a thrilling race to the top taking place, so let's examine the towering contenders vying to claim the crown for planet Earth's preeminent structure. The notion of a skyscraper achieving the unfathomable height of 1 full vertical kilometer, or more than 3,280 feet, started off as little more than a fanciful idea that architect Adrian Smith jotted down for his own musings in the 1990s. At the time, no building had come remotely close. The loftiest man-made structure, Toronto's CN Tower, built in 1976, stood little over half that height at 553 meters. Undeterred, Smith drafted his first rough illustrations of what would become the Jeddah Tower from a spark of inspiration. The images displayed a streamlined tripod form that elegantly tapered as it ascended into the heavens. Smith shelved his drawings for over a decade, until a chance opportunity emerged when Saudi investors sought designs for a new record-shattering structure that could surpass Dubai's recently opened Burj Khalifa. Smith pitched his concept for the first true mega-tall skyscraper capable of achieving the dream of 1 vertical kilometer. Backers were intrigued enough to engage Smith's firm for initial planning phases in late 2008. The seeds had been planted to nurture this outrageous vision into tangible reality. With financial resources secured by 2011 from Saudi Prince Al Waleed's Kingdom Holding Company, the architectural and engineering team set forth to tackle the daunting obstacles. Advanced computer software allowed exhaustive digital modeling to map out the tower's unique tripod footprint, central reinforced core, exterior load transfers, and tapered spine. Every minute adjustment was analyzed for optimizing floor space, flexibility, wind resilience, and, crucially, unprecedented stability despite its insane height. Proprietary programs tailor-made for Kingdom Tower let engineers simulate and visualize stresses like never before. Traditional design methodologies simply wouldn't apply at this altitude. Early projections from these software tests suggested the final height could potentially exceed a staggering 5,280 feet, or 1 full mile. But keeping the concept grounded, the official specification was set at a modest 3,281 feet, or 1 kilometer. After scrutinizing various sites in the Middle East, Jeddah's coastal location and commercial outlook were deemed the ideal fit as the physical and metaphorical foundation, with boundaries pushed to limits once deemed impossible. Real-world groundbreaking commenced on the tower's gravity-defying edifice in early 2013. With the foundations finished, the vertical progression of the tower's concrete central core ramped up year after year. By 2016, the skyscraper had already risen nearly 50 stories and 200 meters into the heavens. However, around this time, complications began to emerge regarding payments to contractors that finally brought work to a frustrating halt in 2018, with the main tower only about 30% completed. The hiatus did provide an opportunity for intense reassessment of the remaining challenges. Key considerations revolved around material selection, elevator systems, wind loads, and even the dynamic movements of the tower itself. For example, the client insisted on conventional concrete as the primary building material over higher grade options, but utilizing pumps and elevators to move concrete upward becomes vastly more difficult and expensive the higher you go. These limitations resulted in a design change, the top 35 stories will consist of a lighter steel spire housing only technical equipment. Speaking of elevators, the Jeddah Tower will require a mind-boggling total of 57 to shuttle occupants efficiently. The cables alone will utilize cutting-edge carbon fiber to handle the demands. And somewhat counterintuitively, the tower's designed to sway almost 2 full meters back and forth at its highest occupied floor during intense wind events without structural failure. State-of-the-art technology and modeling have shown that this movement should be able to absorb and dissipate wind energy at such heights without significantly impacting day-to-day operations. But it exemplifies why buildings of this proportion are truly in an engineering class of their own. The Jeddah Tower figures prominently in Saudi Arabia's ongoing modernization initiatives as part of its Vision 2030 plan, implemented a few years after early construction began. Forward-thinking members of the royal family and business elite recognized that economic diversification was crucial to reducing oil dependence in an increasingly unstable energy market. The construction sector, in particular, offered tantalizing potential with its multiplier effect on jobs and growth. Jeddah Tower provided the perfect flagship initiative to catalyze development. Its backers, including Prince Al-Waleed, marketed it as a source of national pride, showcasing the country's emerging technological leadership. But they also ensured the megastructure would provide pragmatic commercial opportunities at the heart of a reimagined Jeddah. In some respects, Jeddah Tower mirrors aspects of Dubai's Burj Khalifa mixed-use philosophy, but on a grander scale. Roughly the lower two-thirds of the tower will incorporate elite residential apartments and condos with the choicest panoramic views anywhere on the planet. Soaring atrium spaces allow luxuriant greenery and trees to populate lobbies and common areas. Sky gardens and an expansive open-air pool deck adorn intermediate floors. The section above houses Class A commercial office space for lease, along with 3 luxury hotels and numerous fine dining establishments. Well-heeled visitors can ascend to the 2 highest habitable levels, holding the world's loftiest indoor observation deck, over 150 meters above Burj Khalifa's own similar deck. An open-frame 35-story ornamental spire tops off Jeddah Tower's architectural profile, completing the height of the tower that soars more than 3,000 feet into the heavens. Besides catering to wealthy residents and businesses, the tower intends to draw floods of tourists who will gaze upward in awe at its record-breaking height. Less than 50 kilometers away, Jeddah Economic City is also under development, where officials plan to provide dining and entertainment for the projected overflow of visitors drawn by the visually stunning Jeddah Tower. Rising in the distance, the Jeddah Tower will function as the sparkling centerpiece of an entire regional tourism industry if all goes according to the kingdom's Vision 2030 plan. Of course, while the tower visually proclaims opulence, its broader symbolism conveys Saudi Arabia's strengthened global status and focus on future prosperity. After vertical building progress halted in 2018, speculation swirled about whether financial disputes might permanently shelve the tower. But officials reiterated their commitment during the unanticipated 5-year pause. The hiatus offered extended planning time to reassess challenges, material logistics, and viability of building techniques at heights never before attempted. One aspect reconsidered was whether to use higher-strength concrete above a certain threshold to mitigate pumping limitations, but the original specification for conventional concrete remained to streamline subcontracting. Facade glass also underwent wind tunnel optimization. Carbon fiber test cables were put through extreme tension trials to determine breaking points for quality assurance. Reevaluations during this inactive period increased confidence in the smooth resumption. In September 2022, project principals announced the long-awaited continuation of construction by soliciting bids for a new primary contractor. The Saudi Bin Laden Group spearheaded early progress, but parted ways amicably due to shifted priorities, according to officials. Now, heavy construction giants from China, Europe, and the Middle East are vying for the high-profile contract. Building Earth's first 1-kilometer tower will cement its prestige, but represents a monumental coordination and engineering trial. Strict selection criteria has been applied to assess technical expertise, specialized equipment capabilities, and experience with super tall structures. Safety considerations also loom large over this immense project. The short list of qualified contractors will present comprehensive action plans and budgeting tied to incentives for timely benchmarks. JEC's intention to pick up the pace once new builders are on board suggests confidence regarding swift progress to come. Ever since Dubai's Burj Khalifa claimed the mantle of the world's tallest building when opening in 2010 at 828 meters, Saudi Arabia yearned to take bragging rights from its neighbor to the east. The Kingdom Tower, Jeddah Tower's initial name, broke ground just 3 years later, specifically designed to surpass the Burj's lofty elevation. But it wasn't long before Burj's sponsors in the UAE began designing an even more outrageous successor called Dubai Creek Tower, which the main developer, Emaar Properties, claimed would be at least 1,300 meters, or more than 4,200 feet tall. Breaking ground in 2016 with a projected completion date of 2021, it looked as though Dubai would keep the title of world's tallest, especially after construction stalled on the Jeddah Tower in 2018. But construction efforts on the Dubai Tower also faltered in 2019, and in 2020, the COVID pandemic brought everything to a grinding halt, calling into question when, if ever, the height of Burj Khalifa would be surpassed and the 1 kilometer ceiling broken. Interestingly, soon after the announcement that Jeddah Tower's construction was to resume, Dubai authorities also declared they were remobilizing resources to bring Dubai Creek Tower to fruition. Yet no firm dates were offered, and the project remained shrouded in secrecy, unlike the relative transparency surrounding Jeddah Tower's rebirth. This back-and-forth one-upmanship has created quite the spectacle of rivalry between the two nations, and who will be the first in their race to the literal top is still an open question. But for Saudi rulers and real estate investors, Jeddah Tower represents far more than steel and concrete. It's become a tangible personification of its Vision 2030 goals to diversify the economy and catapult the country towards first world innovation status, reigniting progress after years of uncertainties meant to demonstrate the kingdom's resilience, as well as its technological capabilities to the world. Indeed, the structure itself will harmoniously integrate forward-looking sustainable features too, like responsive sun-tracking window tints and passive cooling ventilation that reduce energy demands despite the extreme climate. Similar to the space race of previous decades, the building of such monumental superstructures erected to dominate skylines is a source of national pride for the people of each nation. The Jeddah Tower encapsulates the power of vision and the heights of human ambition, with the goal of ascending human living spaces to the heavens. Construction's commenced once again on this pioneering landmark, looking to claim the title of Earth's tallest and first full-kilometer-high building. What do you think of the Jeddah Tower? Will it be the first to dominate the height of the Burj, or will Dubai steal back the record before it's even lost? Leave your thoughts in the comments below, and don't forget to like and subscribe to Futurescapes. Thanks for tuning in!